I would like to see a video explaining how Loki and Ash's stealth multiplier works when invisibility is active. Sure, let's solve a practical problem. There's a number of not much talked about modifiers to damage, which Pocket Infinity makes a good point to bring up. I'm going to go over the different modifiers you can encounter in stealth and finishers. Oh, and before you ask, this is melee only. Guns get no such benefits. Maybe they should, or maybe have their own system perhaps. Let me know in the comments if you think there should be some kind of finisher system for guns as well. So first, I just want to remind you of a few pieces which affect normal melee damage. That is base damage, which is what the weapon is naturally capable of, and then your base damage increase, so pressure point or things like condition overload. This is then stacked up with elemental and physical mods. And you can add on then criticals, both for critical chance and for critical multiplier. Stances also affect your damage in melee. Those curious capacity increasing things with combos that seemingly just say So yeah, that's the basics for damage. This is of course then affected by things like enemy resistances, but literally every weapon and ability deals with that. So we'll take some time and skip over that. As we can already see though, there's quite a bit that goes into melee damage, and then stealth comes along. When the enemy cannot detect you, regardless if they are alert or not, your melee attacks gain a stealth bonus. This will be lost if they see you, or if they feel you bump into them. This penalty does fade very quickly though, so if they see you but quickly lose sight of you, you can still get a stealth bonus later. Usually the problem is if they've seen you, hear you or feel you, they'll become alert, and will seemingly just grow eyes in the back of their head. It's kinda hard to stealth attack someone who can react to a fly sneezing. Instead, going invisible fixes that, meaning as long as you are invisible, you can get the stealth bonus. I've tested this with Loki, Ivara, Ash and Octavia, and all of them got their stealth damage bonus, again if you don't bump into the enemies. This bonus will add up to 100% of your melee damage on there, plus an extra 20% for every rank your melee weapon has, up to rank 30. That's a 700% damage buff in total, meaning you're dealing 8 times normal damage. This applies to all stealth melee hits, but it's additive alongside crits. So that means if you have a crit multiplier 3 times, and a max rank weapon deals 8 times damage on a stealth hit, that's a total of 10 times damage on a stealth crit. As a result, crits don't scale well with stealth. Do both if you've got the space for modding, but it's typically best to focus on just one. This calculation is all based on your melee damage stat. Stances will deal more damage than that base damage, adding in seemingly random multipliers and forced procs here or there. So if the math doesn't add up when you're trying it out in practice, check what you're getting from your stance first. Finishers then come in 4 different types. That's stealth finishers, vulnerable finishers, ground finishers, and mercy kills. Stealth finishers are the visible prompt that comes up on an unalerted enemy, which defaults to X on PC. You walk up behind them without bumping into them, because that would soft alert them, and stealth attack using the prompt. This provides a damage multiplier based on your weapon type, and this is multiplied by the stealth and crit bonus. So if you have an 8x stealth and a 2x crit, which is bringing you normally up to 9x multiplier, an 8x stealth finisher modifier will make that 8x9, so 72x damage. Also, stealth finishers deal true damage, bypassing any resistance such as armor. Now, to make things confusing, elemental and physical mods only apply half their bonus when used for these finishers. So a 90% elemental mod will only increase the damage by 45% on the finisher, but the damage is still converted to true damage. Vulnerable finishers then are the front and rear finishers you can attempt using the same interact button, except you get no prompt for this. Instead, it's when an enemy has been made open to such a finisher using an ability. There are various ways of doing this, from incapacitating them, like with Equinox's Rest, to briefly opening them up, such as Gaara's passive blindness. Or you can make them permanently exposed, like we're using Narumon's executing dash. Certain weapons or daggers, various abilities, and even the arcane Exodia Hunt can all set up an enemy for a finisher for various durations. Vulnerable finishers have the same equation for handling damage as stealth finishers, including the true damage conversion, and also including elemental and physical mod bonuses being halved. However, these finishers sometimes use different multipliers to the stealth ones. I'm gonna guess it's to do with making some weapon differentiation and distinction, but it all ends up feeling a little bit arbitrary. For most weapons though, they keep a consistent approach to multipliers, so I'll show a table at the end of this with all the modifiers for all your finishers. Ground finishers then differ quite notably from the other finishers in that they do not deal true damage, instead retaining your original damage profile. This means that enemy weaknesses and resistances come into play, and also so does enemy armor. As a result, ground finishers are much weaker against higher level Grineer. Ground finishers not only do not have a prompt, they use the normal melee attack button, and only when you're right next to a knockdown enemy. Now making up for this, ground finishers do typically have higher multipliers to their damage, with fists, claws, and sparring weapons all going up to 30 times multiplier. Though there are some exceptions like Scythes, again, for reasons. In my experience, setting up a ground finisher will normally mean the enemy is alerted, so you lose out on any stealth modifiers. So whilst ground finishers are a thing, and they'll give you a lot more base damage than the normal attacks, building around it is the same as building around Gaara's Splinter Storm for damage. It's doable, but it's a complete waste of time and effort. So then for these finishers, here's the table with all the multipliers for the various finishers. If the box has a diamond in it, that multiplier is split across multiple hits in the one animation. So the total between all of those hits gets up to that high. For all finishers though, the animation speed is fixed regardless of the weapon stats, and instead it's sped up using your attack speed mods, up to a limit of 50% extra speed. Any more than that won't actually improve your finisher speed, no matter how hard you try. The last finisher type then are the mercies. These are pretty simple. If you get an enemy low on health, it has a chance to become open to a mercy kill. This requires no weapon, it's available to everyone, and always deals true damage equal to the enemy's remaining health plus one, which basically means it's a guaranteed kill. It comes with a somewhat cinematic animation, and it can accrue various buffs from mods attached to the Paraton. That said, it can be inconsistent to achieve, so it's much more of an added extra. The exception to all of this is with the Kuva Larvelings, Thralls, and Liches. These all require the use of a finisher to kill them, so when you get them down to zero hit points, that prompt will always appear. So that pretty much covers the finishers available in Warframe. The animations are pretty awesome, so do try out a variety and see how they feel for you. Of course, all this information begs the question, why should you care? Well, finishers are, aside from gunblades, silent. This means you can deal a lot of damage to one enemy without getting the attention of others looking on into your way. Stealth farms can grant a substantial amount of affinity for ranking up frames. And if you mess up and let an enemy become alert, just pop into operator mode, kill that one with your amp, that way your stealth multiplier doesn't get lost. Stealth and vulnerable finishers also ignore any armor or resistances, meaning that damage scales well into the higher level missions. You can utilize Banshee's Silence with its augment to further scale this damage on any Warframe, thanks to the fact that Silence is available to be shared through Helminth. Finishers also make you untargetable for the duration of the animation, meaning that you can use this with impunity in groups of enemies where you're able to trigger it, without worrying about getting wiped out for it. Overall though, finishers are a powerful weapon to have to hand when you can utilize the circumstances, either the ones that crop up for you or the ones that you prepare ahead of time. In knowing the power you can wield at a moment's notice, you can make for more efficient runs. So go out there, put on your sneaky shoes, and put that finishing touch on your melee prowess. And of course, if you found this video helpful, make sure to give it a like. If you're new to the channel, please subscribe as well, it definitely helps out the channel. For now though, move quick, strike hard, and fight well, Tenno.